Oh man.
Good morning. 4:50 a.m. Headed to the gym. It's Monday, first Monday of 2018, which means we gotta get going.
So many friends.
Yes, this is Joe. Joe runs social for Sirhan Team. This is Alex. Photographer extraordinaire for the team. And I mean, the hardest part of my day is now over, right? Even though now I feel like I'm gonna throw up all over the place and I'll cover it in some snow. It used to be that I'd work out at night. But as I got older and work got harder and I had more responsibility, then the last thing I wanted to do after a long, hard work day was then go to the gym. Because I'd be exhausted, I'd be tired, I'd be thinking about my day, I'd be thinking about tomorrow. And I always used to think people who woke up super early were fucking crazy. And now I can't imagine doing it any other way, because now by 6:30, 7 o'clock every morning, the hardest part of my day, physically and mentally, is now over. So this is our bathroom. Isn't it amazing? And doing my hair probably takes the longest part of my morning. There's just so much of it, even though most of it's gray. I think that's a good look for today.
Oh, still cold. I wanted to start a vlog because everyone knows me from shows that are incredibly, you know, that are produced, right? I mean, Million Dollar Listing New York is real, it follows my life, but then it's edited, right? And it takes a lot of time. Something that we'll shoot in August doesn't come out until next spring. And this way, I can give real live content, show people what my days are really like as they're happening in rapid speed. And as the Sirhan team continues to grow, and as my machine that I've built continues to grow, I wanna share that with people. Whether it's just for my mom or for everybody else, I'm putting this out there for better and for worse, completely unfiltered, unscripted, and I apologize ahead of time for whatever crazy shit comes out of my mouth. So it's Monday morning now. It is a little before 8 a.m. So my first appointment today starts at 8:30. Someone who's pitching me a project in LA, Beverly Hills actually. And then just to give you a rundown of what my day looks like, it's nonstop appointments, back to back to back to back to back, because that's how I like it. So I'm switching things up a little bit in 2018. It used to be that every Monday I have an all team meeting, every Monday in our Soho office. It's a lot because it's as the team grew bigger and bigger and bigger, having an all team meeting every Monday morning. There's a lot of people, everyone's busy, they're all running around, and it just sort of became me like a professor, you know, talking to people and talking at them and asking them questions. And that's not really what I want team meetings to be about. So now everyone's gonna have a monthly meeting with me once a month, and I broke them into groups, and those groups will be each Monday. And so today, this Monday morning at 10 a.m. will be my first kind of experiment to see how this works. And I give them all homework, and we're all gonna come to the table prepared. This is Jordan. We're doing a vlog now, by the way.
Hello.
Right, everyone's super excited about this. So give me a second. So I'm gonna have a little meeting here and then we'll be back. Hello. How are you, Ryan?
How are you? Nice to meet you.
Good. And update it. I like the wholesale one, it's nice. So let's create something that we can send to, like this call we have with on at 5, right? Some guy in Brooklyn is building a building. We can easily. Yeah, I mean, once we go and meet him and then see, then we can do a real like proposal.
Yeah.
But like a quick thing just to say, hey, I know you know who we are, but here's just something, some side reading. The same reason we do the Sirhan team book, mm-hmm. right? It goes a long way. It's a good first impression before we ever even pick up the phone or go and meet them. Mm-hmm. A lot of my follow-up yesterday, because I was going back through all my emails from 2017, was looking at pitches we went on that we didn't get and then emailing them again and saying, hey, how's the listing going? See, still on the market, what's up? Right? And kind of like re-upping with those people because they went with somebody who came in and said, no, for sure. No, that guy's stupid and crazy and you should list it here. And then they get excited about the listing price and then they don't sell and then it's a disaster. Yeah, so go after those people. So now we are off to a development pitch in Williamsburg. This is our third meeting, right?
Third.
Third meeting.
This is Morgan. Morgan runs new development for the team. So we did one meeting at the building a couple months ago. Developer went quiet, but we follow up. We are on top of them. So our second meeting, I think, went really well. And now this is our third and hopefully our last meeting before we take it on. Okay, perfect. So let's do that and we can reconvene while we're there if you want, just exactly. To touch base on some pricing and some marketing.
Yes.
Okay, so as of right now, I will see you there Wednesday morning.
All right, great. Thank you, Ryan.
All right, bye. So this is our third pitch for a very large project, and you are not allowed to come with us, so we'll be back. Let's go. So that was our weekly developer meeting. So Gene there is from Greenland. On the phone was everyone from Forest City Ratner, our other developer. And so we got to sit and we talk about sales. We go through all the offers, we go through all the deals, we talk about our next event, we talk about our strategy. And this is also our library, which is actually really, really cool. It was done by McNally Jackson out of Soho, you know, the famous book shop. It's very cool. This is a great building. This is a career-defining building for me. We got it. It's the biggest project that I've ever got, you know, in recent memory. And it's in Brooklyn, and it's part of a 22-acre park that is being built. Everything out there, all the construction, that is all coming up. It's going to be new condos, new rental buildings. It's amazing. It's the biggest project in all of Brooklyn. And who's selling it? Oh, I am. So now we got to go to Million Dollar Listing in the city, 45th Street, and we are late, so let's go. So 2018 for most people with picking up with home searches and getting back to work and all that really starts this week. So I think we'll notice a big tick up and we want to try to take advantage of that as much as we possibly can. So we are on West 45th Street right now. This is where the Million Dollar Listing New York office is. And once a week we come here and we have a meeting where I tell them what I'm about to put on the market, what deals I have going on, if I think that someone's gonna make an offer on something we're already filming. That way we're all on the same page and I know kind of what we're gonna film this week or at least have an idea. What's going on? I talk to a lot of different salespeople and they all ask me like, what do I need to do? How do I sell? And that's such a big, vague question. How do I sell? And I always think back to what someone told me a long, long time ago, which is there's the two P's. Right? P is in Peter. You've got persistence and you've got push. And a lot of people think that they're the same thing. A lot of people confuse the two. A lot of people are pushy when they should just be persistent. And a lot of people are persistent when maybe they should push just a little bit. And most people get confused. But if you can figure out the fine line between the two and not just have it be a gray area, but very, very succinct, I'm going to be persistent today with this client and I'm going to push this client today, then you'll be a much better salesperson. That's what I tell everybody. Remember the two P's. It's very, very, very important. There's no other P's, just the two. And I've got one last appointment. Well, it's not my last appointment. It's a pitch that we're doing in that building up there for another massive new project on 34th Street. And I can't take you up with me. And then after that, I've got one and then two client dinners. First one's in Manhattan, next one's in Brooklyn. Then I'll go back, I'll pass out by like 11 or 12, and then I'll wake up in the morning and start it all over again. So that's it. That's my first vlog. Leave comments for me. I want to know what you want to see more of. You want to see more real estate? You want to see more Yuri? You want to see more Amelia? You want to see more me jumping around Times Square, chirping like a chicken? Let's do it. And I'll see you next time, because, oh shit, I gotta go. Today's day one of the vlog. Now it's over. It's 11 p.m. We're about to pass out, right?
You are.
Oh, Amelia likes to stay up. Amelia, I fall asleep right away, and then Amelia stays up and she reads. And then I wake up to all the text messages and all the links and all the Pinterest of all the things that I need to think about first thing in the morning.
It's important that one of us thinks while the other one sleeps.
That's how you make a marriage work. So that's end of the day, vlog one. I hope you liked it. Catch you on the next one. I let it go, surrender control.